Good afternoon, I'm Sheriff Randy Smith. We're here, myself and Chief Andel, Slidell Police Chief, as two of the top law enforcement officials of St. Tammany Parish to oppose casino here in Slidell in our parish. We cannot afford to gamble with public safety here in safe St. Tammany Parish. I have met with several small business owners that are back on their feet from the pandemic, getting somewhat back to normal, and having to deal with staff to work. No at all on the criminal increase in criminal activity that issues a casino could possibly bring to our area were provided to either one of us. From statistics we've gathered from the FBI, it shows an increase in areas with casinos to involve human trafficking, prostitution, substance abuse, thefts, felony, and misdemeanor, an increase in divorce, and unfortunately suicides increase. We have one of the highest suicide rates here in St. Tammany Parish out of the whole state. We don't need that to increase. Me and the chief really have spoken about this a few times, but we're kind of waiting on whether or not the state lawmakers were going to approve this or the governor would veto this bill, and apparently not. There's a council meeting I know tomorrow night. There are parish council members who will be voting on this to allow this to go back to our citizens, our voters here in the parish, to allow a casino. I am voicing my opinion as the chief together, saying that we work hard and we rely on our citizens to build trust and keep St. Tammany in the state. We see what's going on across the lake in other areas, a high rate of criminal activity and violent crimes. We don't need that here. I think that their smoke and mirrors have been provided by information or lack of thereof, information provided to us on what a casino can do. I know it's sold to us that it's a revenue maker, that it could possibly bring in millions of dollars in revenue for our parish. But I don't believe that's true. There are other ways that we can work with our citizens and our business owners to rely on raising or developing monies needed to keep our parish safe and successful. We are not against gambling by no means. We just don't want it here in St. Tammany Parish, especially in Slidell. Go to New Orleans, go to Mississippi, they're established. They have casinos and folks support those casinos. I'm not against gambling. We just don't want that in our parish. Several faith-based groups have reached out to me with their concerns and are against and oppose a casino in St. Tammany Parish. Special council meeting will be tomorrow night regarding a vote to bring a vote back to our citizens. We're asking you if you have any opposition to this casino coming to our parish, show up and oppose it. Speak your mind. I plan to be there as well. And I'm asking the parish council members who see this today to reconsider their vote of yes and think about their constituents, think about our faith-based community, think about the safety that we have here in this parish that we work hard every day, putting our lives on the line each and every day to keep this one of the safest parishes. And we want to remain and continue to do that. Again, we are here today saying there are other ways of revenue out there for our parish. A casino, to me, is not one of them. Chief, you would?
We're asking the parish tomorrow night to put this on hold. We need some more studies done in this area to be able to make the right decision on whether we want a casino here in Slidell. I can tell you this. The citizens of Slidell voted me in several years ago to run an efficient police department. We have worked with the city. They just gave us some additional personnel. We just redid our pay plan. We have now caught up with the issues we were facing with personnel. Now with the casino possibly coming into town, that is going to have an adverse effect on public safety. We cannot afford that in Slidell. We don't want an adverse criminal element coming into Slidell. So we're asking the parish council tomorrow night, think about that. We need some studies placed on the table. I haven't even talked to the company P2E about public safety. I've yet to be able to have a conversation with them prior to this coming public several months back. So we're asking, put this on hold. Give us an opportunity to read some studies. Thank you.
All right, with that being said, I'm opening it up for questions. If anybody has any questions on our decision and why we waited so late, be glad to try to answer them.
Sure, Smith, they did talk about a substation, building a substation, and also giving the sheriff's office a share of 5% of revenue.
2%.
Oh, 2%. There's 2% of the 5%.
They're right, correct.
So did they talk to you at all about
these folks twice. And it was they were asking if they could meet with me to provide funds down the road to provide a substation for our deputies and reimburse us like the school board does for extra manpower to patrol not only the area of the casino, but the subdivisions within. And of course, my answer to that was sure, if it goes that far and it is established, which would be down the road a few years, we would work with them to provide the best coverage in that area, mainly to our citizens in that area, who I understand a lot of them are against it. But there was some talks made, but there was never any strategic surveys or any comprehensive plans put before me from them, and in fact, from some of their other areas they may have casinos in. So we did our own homework looking at statistics on what these casinos do to an area. We are not a booming society. It's not a booming area as far as entertainment, and I think most of the folks like it that way, and we don't want to change that. You know, we rely on our municipalities to do their own parks and fairs, and we do well with that. I just don't see the casino is the answer. And I think everybody's looking at it as a revenue base and not thinking along the means that this brings a lot of criminal unknowns and crime. So with that being said, any other questions? Yes, sir.
So Sheriff, was there if they offered a higher percentage of revenue?
It's not about, they could offer me as much money as they think they can give us or support us, including the parish, the city, and other entities that they said would benefit of the 5% net profits. It just doesn't add up. It could take years to see a penny from these revenues. And I don't think that the gamble we would be taking voting on a casino here outweighs those revenues. Yes, sir.
Did you say they asked you to pay to build the substation?
No, they offered, if this thing is passed, they offered me to come in and put a substation in that area that we could utilize it with extra manpower to not only patrol the areas of the casino, but the subdivisions that are closest and affected by the clientele that the casino brings in. That makes sense. Yes, sir, in the back.
Hey, you kind of touched on it a little bit. Can you explain more into why you waited until 11 hours to make this request?
And that's a good question. I've not been reached out and spoken to from some of the lawmakers here in our area that sponsored this bill. And nothing against them. I see that a lot of lawmakers, not only here in our parish, are looking for revenue. We're all looking for revenues. And I support some of those ideas that we've met and talked about, but not this one. I didn't think it would pass the House floor or the Senate. And now that it's coming back to the parish for one last vote, this that will allow this to go to the voters, It is up to the voters to make that decision. It depends on how the vote goes tomorrow night. I'm just saying, we, as the top law enforcement officials in this parish, are against a casino. And we are trying to let the public know that think that me and this gentleman, this chief, are supportive of it. Most of the people I run into on the street, they say, we understand you're supporting it because some of the wording and some of the articles that y'all have written makes it sound like I'm supporting it just because they're giving me the supporting me with a substation or extra manpower. I'm here to tell you that's incorrect and not true. I'd rather see us find other means of revenue than a casino here. What? Yes, sir.
I know in your favor.
Yeah.
What's your thoughts on whether you think something in that location, some people think it'll draw some New Orleans East crime over here. Do you think it would actually bring much of that?
We're doing our best to prevent that from happening now without a casino. Would that add to our beefing up the manpower and working closer around the clock with trying to keep that criminal element out of our parish? Absolutely. Yes, I think a casino would definitely cause us more grief and heartache and see an uptick in criminal activity. It's just that it runs with it. It's a fact. I'm not making this up.
The casino, Slidell is not a tourist destination. That casino is going to be, if it's successful, it's going to be our local residents in the 25-30 mile radius that's going to go to that casino. So obviously that's going to bring in citizens from different areas around here.
Yes, sir.
Sheriff, you talked about, I'm very interested in this, the link that the FBI data, I believe, about sex trafficking and prostitution, there being a link between those sorts of criminal activities and casinos. And I was just wondering if you could comment if there's anything to be said about the fact that we're talking about the proposed location is at a convergence of three major interstates, if that geography has any bearing on those.
We actually work close with the state police, our federal partners, to combat human trafficking here in our own parish, because we know that the I-10-12 corridor right here through Slidell brings some of those victims through here and some of the people that are moving them. A casino would just add to that, and we would see an increase in those type of criminal activities in our parish that we don't need. We don't want to see that. We're doing the best we can with our partnership with other law enforcement to combat that now. But when you bring in a casino, you'll see an uptick in criminal activity. Again, an uptick in substance abuse and thefts, criminal activity. And we're, like I said, we're wearing ourselves thin now trying to deal with what we have to deal with here now in our area without adding to that. And I'm not the expert, but I don't think the citizens standing together, and they're not against gambling. They just don't want to see it here. My mother, Lord rest her soul, she had a bumper sticker when this thing came to life 20 years ago, and she says, I'm not supporting a casino. But she's over at the Island View every other weekend with a free room and free play and loved it. She says, I just don't want it here. And that's the message I'm also receiving from our senior citizens. They want to go enjoy the casino in Mississippi or New Orleans. But they'll tell you right now in a heartbeat, we don't want it here. Yes, sir.
Sheriff, if the casino passes on Wednesday, and you get 2%, how much of the net, how much of that is guaranteed money? How do you guarantee what the net's going to be?
There's no guarantee. When you're dealing with a casino, from my understanding and research, they're still in debt from the time they open till the time they become successful, which is never. Then it could become dormant, it could fail, it could be sold. We don't know. Those are the unknowns that we haven't discussed with any of the parish council members or any of our lawmakers. I'm just telling you, these two guys and a lot of other people within our community are concerned and don't want to see this casino. Yes, sir.
I'm just curious. It seems like y'all are on the tail end of this. Are you telling me that all of this planning from the casino and the legislators and everything, and y'all, when were y'all brought into the loop? Because it seems like y'all were kind of left out, and I would have thought that the lawmakers or the law keepers yourselves would have been brought in on the front end of this thing.
I had two meetings with the group that planned the casino. They went well, and again, they were like, you know, talking about percentages and net proceeds going to all these different entities, which sounds good. It sounds good for a parish, especially the parish, a parish we're in that could use some financial stability, because we see the future glim with some of the tax monies that are going away or have gone away. So I just don't think this is the route to take, you know. And we're willing to work with the council. We're willing to work with these committees that have been formulated to find other ways to generate revenue. But this is not one of them that I'm going to support, and I think the chief states
John, to answer your question on that, I found out the same time everybody else found out. As the chief of police of the largest city in the parish, I found out when everybody else found out.
All right, that wraps it up. Thank y'all very much, and I hope to see y'all tomorrow night at the council meeting. How's that?